It was 4 o'clock in the morning because I couldn't sleep. Excited and nervous at the same time.
Chilling in the garden, really. Caden got up about 5:30.
Mummy told me to go back to bed because I needed to sleep because it was going to be a long day till midnight.
All the girls were getting ready and doing breakfast, and so I had a bit of a lay-in, and then I was generally helping out downstairs with what I could.
It was quite chilled, actually. It was quite nice and relaxed. It wasn't as hectic, or I didn't have to worry too much.
Everyone was outside in the garden, and we had a bacon sandwich.
Get my jacket and suit on by about 10:30.
We were really chilled, actually, until the last half hour.
When the hair and makeup stylist came, which was amazing. They did an amazing job. It was really nice and relaxed.
Gemma seemed very chilled out till she got the wedding dress on, and then I think it hit her a bit.
Everyone was, like, so rushed.
Putting on my dress was, like, absolutely amazing, because I'm not really a girly girl. It was lovely seeing a different side to me.
Gemma was excited, a bit nervous.
Mum was literally just stressing.
Got up, had some breakfast. Spent the 3 hours trying to turn me into a reasonably attractive man, I guess.
They said they were getting up early for breakfast, and by the time I'd finished mine, they were only just arriving.
The weather's very hot, very, very muggy.
I had coached Caden and written a speech for him.
I think I was more nervous about the day going well than I was about marrying Gemma, just because I know that's what I wanted.
Quite calm, actually. I was surprised.
Saw Jason beforehand. He looked very smart, a little nervous. He said yesterday that he just hoped that Gemma would turn up, so perhaps that was playing on his mind, I don't know.
Pretty normal day.
Best men and groomsmen were keeping him calm.
That was when I started getting nervous a little bit, I think, waiting for you to arrive.
The nerves didn't actually kick in, to be honest, as much as I thought it would do until we parked. And when I started seeing everybody standing around, I had a bit of a freak out in the car.
He was standing with his two best men.
An air of expectancy.
At that point, I think Jason almost started quite a lot of people off because he became a little bit emotional before Gemma and Caden arrived.
Made it clear to Jason that if we ever got married, I would have to have my best friend by my side, which is Caden. He was just as nervous as I was, really.
I said good luck. That's it. We went down the aisle.
Because more focusing on not falling flat on my face than anything.
I was looking at Gemma and I was looking at Caden as well, and he looked very pleased with himself.
I had no idea what you were going to look like when you came down. Everyone was just staring at me, waiting for me to start crying, which I did on cue.
Wasn't it towards the place when Jason started crying?
Gemma looked amazing.
Gemma, I'll give you this ring.
Jason, I give you this ring.
It's a symbol of our marriage.
I love the token of
my love.
My love. Sorry, I'll have to do it at some point. My love. A lasting friendship, always and forever.
These are the hands that will passionately love and cherish you through the years.
He's not perfect, you aren't either. But if he can make you laugh at least once, cause you to think twice, hold on to him and give him the most you can.
You are indeed husband and wife.
I gave Mum away today. I know Jason would rather have married Princess Leia, but unfortunately she is no longer available. Jason told me that my mum will have to do. I'm very happy that Jason is going to be my stepdad.
I started, like all great love stories, with a formal email asking about martial arts classes and how much they cost. You look absolutely stunning today, and I feel so lucky to be here. They say you don't marry someone you can live with, but you marry someone you couldn't live without.
Oh, hay fever again.
I'm so happy to be your husband and Caden's stepdad.
First realised I was part of this wedding when Jason said we should organise his stag do. Well, mate, I hope your priorities have changed, because take it from me, a wedding is for life, not just a stag do.
So they arranged their first date. I asked them both separate occasions how it went. They both said the same thing. Jason didn't say a word, and Gemma said too much. But you know what they say, guys? Opposites do attract, yeah?
Gemma and Jason, I wish you all the luck, and just look after each other. And I know you love each other very much.
Never go to bed on an argument.
They're having this long, happy life together.
Jason and Gemma, you made a very good choice, not just with your bride, but with the venue as well. Have a lovely long life together.
Enjoy your life together. Live life to the full every day.
Jason, thank you so much for being there for me and always made me feel loved.
Gemma, thank you for putting up with me. I can't think of anyone I'd rather spend my life with. The best thing that's ever happened to me. Both of you. Say you
will. I love you both. You're amazing parents.
Marry me.
don't split up.